Hello and welcome to Backlog Conquering. It's part 4 of playing Foul Play. In the last video, we finished the second play, I think, and going into the third. So we're just going to continue the story. And I apologise, my voice is a little croaky today. It's been a long day. So what are we up to? Yeah, we're on the third play. So we finished the second one, won the third. We're up to Act 2. Zombie attack. On the left side, we've got challenges. These are often really difficult, so I've not really managed to complete many of them. Well, let's dive in and keep going. Ah yes, I recognize that triangle anywhere. I reckon I will. Looks like a kraken. Octopi, alright. So as ever with this game, it's been a little while since I played it, so it's good to try and remember what buttons do what. And as ever, the combo system doesn't last long enough. So if you're unfamiliar with the game, the reason why there's an audience is because it's a play, hence the name Foul Play. And we've got to try and keep them happy. That's what the bar in the middle is for. It's all about keeping the audience happy and excited. So we've got to try and do tricks and stuff. And not get hit especially. But the window for the combo system is also really small. One thing I remember to do is the grabbing, but the cannonball is something I don't quite remember. That was one of the challenges. Sometimes the challenges we can do at any point in the game, other times the game wants us to do them in specific points. At the moment I'm kind of interested to see where the zombies are going to come into this, because they don't look like zombies. We do get a special move as well, like I keep wanting to say Super Saiyan mode, but it's not quite accurate, but I don't want to use it just yet. Uniforms? Oh yes, the squid away uniforms. Ah, maybe these are zombies. Yeah, sorry if we're going through the text a bit too quickly. Feel free to pause it. In a game series as long as this is, you know, I have to make things a little shorter here and there. Been unlocking new moves and abilities as we've been playing, and it's difficult to kind of remember all of them, so it could be that this whole grabbing thing might be something that I've unlocked in the last video, but I just don't remember. Or it could be something specific to this enemy, because, you know, tentacles. Of course, the language and the setting has been really fun. Some of these battles at this difficulty level do feel like they are a little bit too long. I would prefer to enjoy a bit more of the story. So if you do play this game, I would honestly recommend just going straight into the kind of easy difficulty level and just sit back and enjoy the humor of the story. It's really well done. At the moment, we're playing on normal. This is what you can expect if you play on normal. protect the innocent. Oh, it's gonna be difficult. Got three to protect. And they're all over. Oh, we've lost one already. So, nope, we're not gonna do that. Again, as you can see on the bottom left, it's tied to the challenges. Trying to get the combo meter in the middle, as well as getting combos on the side, trying to get up. We've got to get 75 combos. This is another challenge we've got to try and do. These tend to be quite awkward. Especially with these with the tentacles. It's going to be really difficult to... Yeah, alright. So there, we lost it. So difficult. These tentacles. Super Saiyan mode. We get double the combos for doing this successfully, so hopefully that'll get us... Nope! It was a waste of time. So typically in these sections we also sometimes get like a little extra enemies to give us a chance to complete the challenge, but... We're not going to be able to do it. And that's fine. Like I said, I'm more than happy to keep playing for the story. As soon as you see that circle on the screen, you've got to start countering with the circle button. That would be hilarious if I get the 75 now. That would be funny and also annoying, but that's how it goes sometimes. Nah, it's so difficult. Thankfully, I haven't come up, oh, I haven't died in this game yet. In the middle, it's kind of easy to build up the combo system to get the audience on your side. So whilst it does go down, it doesn't take too much to get it back up again. Obviously the difficulty is getting it higher to get more and more points. As you probably saw at the start, each act is scored. So that's kind of the replayability of this game, is getting higher scores, unlocking more combos and completing more challenges. Every time you complete all three challenges in the stage, you unlock a special kind of rune or power up. Ooh, what's gonna happen? That's good. I like this kind of humour. The old English style is kind of fun, but the humour's on point. Some very good writers in this game. Oh no, all cool. So, time for extra points. They're all staying on the side, it's annoying. Three stars is pretty average, not too bad. Great combo is not too bad. So yeah, you know, nothing spectacular, but me, I'm playing because I'm enjoying the story and the characters. The action, the gameplay, I could do with less, but let's keep going, it's enjoyable. New move, okay. None. I'm not worried about saving. I'm not playing this on Vita, so it's not a problem. Launch multiple enemies, okay? And you see it says 8. That means I'm level 8. So there is some sort of leveling up system, but it's not being explored or explained or tutorialized at all, so I'm not worried about it. Oh, Poseidon? Oh, we're going to Atlantis. Good question. Are we having a boss fight in the middle? Interesting. This is a mermaid. What is this? Kind of weird. Spookiness. Oh, this is completely new. I'm enjoying this kind of new take on the idea. So you've got the combo already in the 70s. Better than the other game we had. The other act, I should say. So perfect scenes means that I wasn't hit. Which, as you can imagine, is kind of rare. Got stuck behind the weed. No, lost the combo. You see that, like, powered up, throwing the air, that's kind of the new move. I'm not done yet. Whoa, what are these new guys? Let's power up, let's get this ready. Oh, I got hit. Nuts. All that stuff happening in the corner, I missed that they were shooting at me or trying to attack. Ah, oh, I missed it again. Yeah, I'm probably not going to get a perfect one here. So difficult to get right. It's not impossible to grab big enemies, but in this case, like that, dodge is more a case of well, it's actually dodging. Oh, X is in the eyes, got one. There we go. isn't over yet. See what I mean by the battles seem feeling just a little bit too long? It's a case of this. In the bottom we've got a timer as well, so we can't dilly dally too long. We've got to properly try and end this. They just keep coming. What's that combo? Ah, there is a way to extend the combo, but you've got to get a special item by doing the challenges. So essentially you have to try and do the challenges to get a way to make the challenges easier. So it kinda sucks. See, the time has gone, so I think we missed it. I'm gonna see how they expect us to complete it that quickly. This has to be the last wave, surely. Go, finally. Him. We're now working for him? Do our goals match or something? Oh cool. Too many. Hey, 4-star. That felt better as well. Completed in under 5 minutes. That's what that timer was. 150 combo. These challenges. Well, they're challenging. Alright, just a couple more on this place finished. Let's keep going. Oh, I did not look at the challenges whatsoever. It is Atlantis, okay. But technological Atlantis, interesting. Perhaps again the Bioshock route. no, do they got an electric attack? That's gonna suck. Thankfully, things. Oh, something electrical there. Maybe that's like an aerial effect, so if I'm standing near them, then I'll get shocked, but it's not gonna fire an electric ball at me. I can only hope. That's funny. Okay, I like that. So it could be that it's not zombies or squid creatures. It could literally be the robots have rebelled. I like that the text in the middle, you can pretty much read most of the Atlantis there. It's like the unknown in Pokemon. You can mostly read what they're trying to say. But it kind of still looks interesting. Yeah, but it does have a bit of a Bioshock feel to it, with city ruins in the background, walking in a tunnel underwater. Not as many automatons though. Feels a little different. But surprisingly not too far away in terms of time period either. That's what Bioshock's, it's around World War I or World War II, I'm not too sure. This is obviously like 1900s-ish. Because of the language and the clothes. I would say like end of Victorian period. That build up to try and flick them both in the air, it's a bit too long. They can easily counter and attack me in that bit. Yeah, I'm trying to get out of the way. Bad use of this power. Well, the meter in the middle, still only one star. Combo system is not forgiving. You feel so close to doing so well and then so easily disappears, and it's like, oh, a bit disheartening at times. Oh, big robot. What does it get, a 75 on this? I can try, but Yes, I was trying to get away, but it didn't work. And again, it's stuck. Caught me on when we landed, that's so unlucky. It's like it's possible, we can easily see it's possible. We need a bit more luck. Yeah, these pictures in the background, just a little fun story. So they basically could be the one with the banner last. Sometimes it's quite easy to do, but what these levels sometimes do is that this is only the first wave. You have to somehow survive two or three waves and not kill the leader in those waves. You'll wait to the end. I decided to give up on the combo then. I wanted to get away from the leader to at least give me a chance to kill at last. Get out of the way. Well, no one else is joining in, so maybe this is just going to be a single wave. Yes, we got one at least. And then there are more. Shocker. Nuts. I was doing really well combering and avoiding and got shocked. So frustrating. That was the thing that got me. Sometimes when you're in the air, it feels like you can avoid all these, but I guess not that lucky, these bigger ones. Ah, oh, we got a 59! Didn't see what caused the combo to stop then. Yeah. No, he went away! Yeah. He killed the combo. Oh, that's so annoying. It is. The game is some sort of Lovecraftian horror. We've got a time on this one. See, it says securable. It doesn't say anything about these things that keeps these robot machines that it's dumping. My guess is, if we can just focus on that robot when it's on the screen, it might be a benefit for us. Not sticking around, is it? Got quite a few hits there, it's really cool. Hopefully it's maybe a good one of these and throw it at it. Oh, it hits itself, it's okay. See this, oh, the health's going down, but I don't know if we can do it quickly enough. Yes, we've got a throw on it. Excellent, it's what I was wanting. Ah, he broke the combo. That's not fair. Cheated. Yes, we've got a challenge done. Okay. Uh-huh. Yep. What are they for? No uncle? Okay. So, final day, final act. so many. Alright, so this play had two bosses in it. These ones have got the tentacles. This is gonna be a annoying one to deal with. It's really tough. His attacks keep giving me in the air as well. It's very difficult to find a way to avoid him whilst also dealing with him. Thankfully this game doesn't have death, so it's not that bad if we get hit a few times. As long as we can quickly try and get the audience on our side, you know, get them enjoying the show, it kind of doesn't matter too much. Obviously, if you were playing this for points and speed run whatnot, then yeah, you'd have a different approach. But at the moment, I'm okay with this. That's another one down. Oh. Nope. More chaotic now. See, I was in the air, high jump, and couldn't avoid it. Walk backwards. Such an annoying thing to do. Stages this boss character's gonna have. How far in Final Fantasy are we gonna get? One stage, two stage, three stages, four? Are we gonna have to fight the city? Or the Lovecraftian horror itself at some point? This is not the final boss. This could actually genuinely be like a two stage boss battle. That's not the final boss, but the final boss is the horror itself. Have to wait and see, I suppose. I think I have 5-starred this one. Which is kind of impressive. close. Go on, let's do it. Ooh, yeah. Another one down. Excellent. Oh. Now. Okay, so that's what happened. Small cane. Not something to be a map that big in. What's this new move gonna be? Hey, first 5-star, excellent. 50, not sure what that's about. I'm not really using the L2 and R2. I wonder what they actually do. So if you're unfamiliar, if you missed the other videos, there's only 5. So we're nearly there. Let's try and do like the first one today. Maybe the first couple. We're under an hour at the moment. Surprisingly in depth. Oh, there you go. That's the year. Would have been cool if the audience were like gasping in shock and horror. At the moment it's lots of whooping and cheering. Oh, I think R2 might be like a dodge roll out of the way. Oh, that might have been a bit more useful if I had remembered to use it. Ah, it doesn't matter. is definitely taking a little bit of effort to get this done. Thankfully the fire's not burning us. I was a little worried about that, because the stage is quite narrow. How far away were we? No, we were so close. Using the R2 does give you much more sort of pace and movement. It's kind of really nice. See, it's like we were so close to doing all three challenges on this stage. So it kind of does have that one more time I can play this again and do better next time about it. Ooh, okay. See, we just got out of that room a little bit quicker. We would have been fine. Oh well. Ah, they're all the way to the bottom is so difficult. We lost the combo because of that. Yeah, using R2 gets you across the stage, but going up and down is still difficult. These battles may be taking a little while, but they're not too difficult. They're not that difficult to avoid. Like, whenever they do a sword attack, there's kind of a long wind-up to it. So there's enough time to hit the dodge button, enough time to get out of the way. So when I've lost the combo, it's mostly been through not getting to the next opponent quick enough, rather than them hitting me. Whereas some of the other enemies, like the Octopi, it was kind of like the tentacles all over the place, it's so difficult to avoid them. They were right there and I still couldn't get a hit in quick enough. Well, that's 3 stars. As we've already seen, I've only had 1 5-star, so not too wide if I don't get there. But a 4-star would be nice, just to show that we did well. Ooh, right. Oh, it just doesn't stop. Okay. Very, very stretching to the point. He's the leader. So he's not like the hired muscle, he's the guy in charge. Interesting. He's subject Zang. Where am I? There I am. Oh, that's so bad. There's no way of avoiding that. Throw his mid end as best I can. Oops, I changed direction. My mistake there. Not exactly doing too much damage to the leader, though. I feel like throwing his men at him aren't doing as much as I'd hoped. Whoa! We're like so close to getting the 5-star. It'd be really cool if we can get him more than once. But there we go. Oh, right at the end there. I think we got it. Yes. All right. Make him bounce, okay. And so we're gonna end it there. We finished the third play, we started the fourth play. It's coming to an end, the story. So I hope you're enjoying it. It is, as I say, the story for me is so much more fun than the action and the fighting. So that's what I'm enjoying the most. But the last few games haven't, few bosses I should say, haven't been that bad. Just with the octopus was a little frustrating, with the tentacles and with the robots, with the electric. That's a little bit much, but so far, so good. So there will be another part. That's the thing with Backlog Conquering, it doesn't have to finish the game. You just have to play it to get an opinion about it. But I'm having fun, so I'm gonna keep going. So until the next Backlog Conquering video, or maybe until I see you checking out some of the other videos, playlists, or YouTube shorts, or maybe I'll see you over at Ko-fi, as a YouTube channel, a small YouTube channel, we get no money from YouTube, so I set up a Ko-fi account to get donations, and we've got a couple of subscription tiers, but of course that's all if you want to. But wherever and whenever I see you again, please take care.